Next, I'd like to talk a little bit about distances in the solar system. So when we draw something like the solar system, you might think of something like this, where the sun is in the center, and here's Mercury going around in its orbit right here around the sun. Here's Venus going around in its orbit. Here's the Earth going around in its orbit and goes around and around and around. So what I'd like to talk about in this video here is what sort of distances are involved here, like how far is it from the sun to Mercury, or how far is it from the sun to Venus, or the sun to Earth. And of course, we have more planets as we go out, which I'm not even drawing there. What about their distances? Well, here you go with a couple of numbers for you here. So we have our sort of way of remembering the planets: my very energetic mother just served us nachos, something like that. So let's just start with that then, and we'll put the sun right here, and we'll put Mercury right here. So it turns out that the distance between the sun and Mercury is something like 36 million miles. 36 million miles. If you go to Venus then, the sun to Venus, that's going to be something like 67 million miles. You go to Earth. Good old Earth out here where we live, Earth, that distance is going to be something like 93 million miles. And this discussion here is really boring, isn't it? Yes, it is. And so the takeaway from this is, please don't memorize these numbers or anything like that. Just remember that planet distances in here are something like not a mile, not 10 miles, not 1,000 miles, but there's something like tens of millions of miles. That generally sets the size of distances between the sun and some planet, tens of millions of miles. So we're not like billions of miles and that sort of thing. Tens of millions of miles generally gets you there. And the reason why this is kind of boring is because when you think a little bit about these numbers here, suppose you think of the distance between SLO and Santa Maria. SLO and Santa Maria. Well, this distance here is about, don't know why I can't get this arrow to look good, this distance is about 40 miles or so. And 40 miles is a very convenient number. It's very easy to remember. But believe it or not, this distance is also something like 2,500,000 inches. And so it would be perfectly reasonable, not reasonable, but it would be perfectly correct to say that the slow Santa Maria distance is 2,500,000 inches. You could just tell someone that, well, you know, Mom, I'm going to Santa Maria now, so I'm going to go drive 2.5 million inches to get there. Now, the person you're talking to might sort of, you know, look at you like that, like you're sort of nuts or something, because 40 miles is much more convenient. And so that's sort of the situation with these two. These numbers, like 93 million miles and 67 million miles, are correct, but they're just too cumbersome to sort of throw around. They're kind of boring to remember. So I wonder if there's an easier way, and indeed there is. So it turns out what might be more important to sort of know about these distances here is what astronomers done is they've taken the Sun-Earth distance here, that 93 million miles, and they call that 1 astronomical unit. That's 1 astronomical unit, or 1 AU. And so with that, you can sort of get a better puzzle of the distances involved here without having to deal with all these awful numbers here. So going back to the original drawing right here, maybe I'll take out this arrow just for a second here, is that, let me get a different color, like say maybe some green here. So what that means here is, instead of drawing 93 million miles between the sun and the Earth, you could just label that as 1 AU. So we'll go back here and go, okay, here's the sun and here's the Earth here, and we're going to just call this distance here not 93 million, we're going to call it 1 AU. Sort of defines the standard for distance in the solar system. If you wanted the distance between sun and Mercury, the sun and Mercury, that's something like 0.4 AU. How about the Sun and Venus? Well, Venus sits in here. That distance in here is going to be something like 0.7 AU. And if you want to go all the way out to Mars, which is this planet we'd all like to maybe visit someday, well, Mars is something like 1.5 AU. So we'll stop there. in terms of the this drawing, we'll talk about the distances to the other planets in just a second here, but we'll stop there at the moment, because now it allows you sort of to have a more digestible view of how big the solar system is. So for example, if you were ever asked about how far is Mercury from the sun, you would say, well, it's about half the distance of the Earth from the sun, because the Earth is 1, Mercury is 0.4, which is, you know, near 0.5, so that sort of gives you an idea that Mercury is about twice as close to the sun as we are. Likewise, Venus is about 70% of our distance to the sun, that kind of thing, and Mars is about 1 Earth distance plus another half out away from the sun. So this sort of gives you a better grasp of how you can state distances with the solar system. 0.4, 0.7, 1 for us, and 1.5 for Mars. The other planets, just sort of out of passing interest for completeness here, Jupiter here is about 5.2 AUs away. Saturn, which is even further, of course, 9.5 AUs. Uranus, that tough to pronounce planet, gets much larger at around 19 AUs. And Neptune, the one with that incredibly long orbit time here, is about 30 AUs.